Recently, head of Amazon Studios Jennifer Salke was interviewed by The Hollywood Reporter via Zoom, along with several other female Hollywood executives. And during this interview, Salke commented about their ambitious Lord of the Rings series currently in production. These comments have triggered somewhat of a backlash from several Tolkien fans, but with further examination, I've come to believe that much of the motivation behind this backlash is unwarranted. Now, I realize that my take regarding her comments might not be too popular, but in making this video, I'm hoping to help shed some light on an example of why context matters when it comes to news reporting, and why it's so important for consumers to read past the headline. First, I'd like to cover the entirety of the portion of her interview where she addresses the Lord of the Rings series. This interview can be found on The Hollywood Reporter's website. I'll leave a link to the article in the description. In this discussion, the interviewer asked Jennifer Salke a question regarding the massive production for the series, saying, quote, "Jen, there were reports about Lord of the Rings, which put the first season budget at $465 million, making it the most expensive series ever. What does that price tag say about the market today, and how well will it need to do to justify that price tag?" So at this moment, I feel it's important to recognize the framing of the questions, and that Salke was asked only about the financing for this ambitious series, and the risk that comes with such an expensive budget, specifically asking how well the series needs to do to justify the price tag. With that in mind, this was Salke's response. Quote, "The market is crazy, as you saw with the Knives Out deal. Netflix paid $469 million for two sequels. This is a full season of a huge world-building show. The number is a sexy headline or a crazy headline that's fun to click on, but that is really building the infrastructure of what will sustain the whole series. But it is a crazy world, and various people on this Zoom, mostly Bella and me, have been in bidding situations where it starts to go incredibly high. There's a lot of wooing, and we have to make decisions on where we want to stretch and where we want to draw the line. As for how many people need to watch Lord of the Rings? A lot. A giant global audience needs to show up to it as appointment television, and we are pretty confident that that will happen." Overall, it appears these comments are pretty basic in terms of the financial concerns. Salke first addresses Amazon's spending itself, citing the competitive market and having to make decisions on how to spend in certain bidding situations and where to draw the line. So it seems that with the legacy of the Lord of the Rings IP, this is what justified its exorbitant price tag. She also remarked on how the scope of the show factors into its production budget, saying that it is a huge world-building show, and considering the series is set in the Second Age, which has not yet been adapted, and which features a different setting and events taking place over the course of roughly 3,500 years, having to spend a lot for bringing such an epic high fantasy world to life certainly seems reasonable. However, the many varied critical responses that I've seen to Jennifer Salke's comments are often only focused on her very last remarks. Again, she is specifically addressing the interviewer's question about justifying the price tag by saying a lot of people need to watch it. Quote, "a giant global audience needs to show up to it as appointment television," and followed by the keywords, "we are pretty confident that will happen." These words at the end of her remarks, stating her confidence in their ability for the series to get such a positive response from audiences around the globe, appears to me to indicate her recognition of the iconic and much-beloved nature of Tolkien's works, as well as their ability to satisfy that same audience. I've seen many news sources and responses merely limited to including only a few choice words from her sentence, and attributing negative connotations to her meaning, implying that she thinks that the IP doesn't already have a global audience. Certainly, when spending this amount of money on a TV series, the hope is that a large audience will watch it to make it a commercial success. However, many recognize that the Lord of the Rings IP itself already has a global appeal, and they have taken issue with her seemingly acting as if that's not the case. On that point, I will say that just the name of an iconic property in regards to a show or movie has not always meant it will be successful. There is no question that Tolkien's works have a huge, dedicated international fan base. However, that is not a guarantee in itself that any adaptation based on his works will be well received, especially if they choose to deviate from the spirit of Tolkien's works and alienate large groups of passionate fans. That being said, it's clear to me that Salky is speaking solely about the TV series itself and not about the IP in terms of global appeal, as the words clearly state that a large global audience needs to tune in to the series to justify their spending. There are concerns also that these words could indicate that they are trying to please everyone and so will most likely end up pleasing no one. I'm certainly not the kind of person to read more into a person's comments, attributing motives or intentions beyond what is simply said. I'd much rather wait for the end product to arrive before passing judgment, as so much can change over the course of production. Her words in of themselves say nothing to me regarding the content of the show and its catering to the international audience. They appear to merely focus on their financial stake in it. The adaptations of Tolkien's The Hobbit and The Lord of the Rings have been met with enormous commercial success. They already know the formula that works for audiences, and that is one which stays true to Tolkien's works, his world-building, and the spirit of his storytelling. One news article in particular that covered this information in a manner which I thought to be quite accurate and fair was written by John F. Trent over on Bounding Into Comics. I'll leave a link in the description below if you'd like to check it out. As the article mentions, Tolkien has written that The Lord of the Rings is a Catholic work, also stating, "That is why I have not put in, or have cut out, practically all references to anything like religion, to cults or practices in the imaginary world. For the religious element is absorbed into the story and the symbolism." While including in his writing themes of religion, war, environmental conservation, they were blended seamlessly into an epic story that everyone could enjoy and find elements to relate to. The article ends by posing a very thought-provoking question, namely, do you think Amazon's Lord of the Rings can appeal to a global audience while also staying true to Tolkien's vision? This is certainly the kind of question that the showrunners and executives over at Amazon should keep in mind. The Tolkien estate's reported veto power over Amazon's creative decisions with the series is intended to keep the studio within the framework of Tolkien's writings. And without more information regarding the content of the series, it's hard to say whether or not these fears of a watering down of Catholicism in his writings and a possible perversion of Tolkien's work in adapting the Second Age will actually come to pass. Many sound arguments can and have been made to legitimize the skepticism, and I certainly have concerns of my own. But in this case, I just don't think a sound argument is being made when it comes to the backlash against what Ms. Salky had to say about the series in this interview. But I'm curious to know what you think about her comments. Do you feel that Salky was out of line to comment on the series' need to maintain a giant global audience? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did, and be sure to subscribe for more Lord of the Rings and other sci-fi and fantasy news and lore. Thank you all so much for your support, and as always, have a very nerdy day.